This is our Hyundai Ioniq electric, and back in December 2022 I fitted these Goodyear all-season tyres, and we have done 26,500 miles since. So in this video I'm just going to have a look at the wear rate of these Goodyear Vector all-season Gen 3 tyres. So this car had done 16,414 miles when I fitted the tyres, and it has now done 43,002 miles. So one of the reasons why I'm making this video is I've just seen a comment on Facebook, someone saying, why would you fit all-season tyres on an EV? Because you're going to get less range, less efficiency. So let's just have a look at the efficiency on this car. Mel, who drives it, doesn't make any effort to drive it efficiently, just drives it normally. Got to remember now where the information is. Here it is. So recent driving, 5.9 miles per kilowatt hour, 5.4, 5.8. You look at all the sort of longer trips, 5.4, 5.9. So we're averaging 6 miles per kilowatt hour on the long trips in the summer months. And then even back here, yeah, anything between 5.5 and 6 miles per kilowatt hour. So even with all season tyres on an EV, we're still getting great efficiency out of this, and if you put some effort into it, you can get that up to 6.5 to 7 with these tyres on. 90% of the viewers of this channel are not subscribed. I'm sorry to ask, but it would help greatly if you would. Just press the subscribe button. It's free and it shows YouTube you like this sort of vehicle related content. If you want to be notified when new videos are released, please click on the bell button also. Thank you, it really helps more than you would imagine. So while they will be slightly less efficient, it's peanuts and it's hardly measurable. But the advantage of an all-season tyre is in the winter, they're going to be a lot safer than running a summer tyre. And that's why we fit them on our cars. So back in December 22, I made a video when I fitted these tyres on the car, and I've just referred back to that video. If you want to see it, I'll put a link to it at the top of the screen and in the video description below. And fortunately on that video, I measured the tread depths when the tyre was new. So I can now compare this after nearly 27,000 miles to what it was like when it was new. So I'm looking at the back wheel first, because these are going to wear better than the front tyre because it's a front wheel drive car. And on these, you don't measure it in the middle because the middle doesn't have quite so much depth. So somewhere here, I can't quite feel it now, there is a tread wear indicator there. So let's measure it just to the side of that. And that's 5.9 millimetres. Let's just try it again. There. 6.2. So when I measured this when it was new, it was 8.1. So we've gone from 8 millimetres, yeah, to 6 millimetres. And then near the tread wear indicator there, that was 7 millimetres or 7.1, and we're now down to 5.7, something like that. Yeah, 5.8. So minimal wear on the back tyres after 26,600 miles. And now the front tyres, and of course these are going to be worn much more because it's a front wheel drive car. So if I just measure to the side of that, it's 3.9 millimetres. 3.9 millimetres. So at that point, it was 8.1 when it's new. The legal limit is 1.6, but in reality, I'll probably change it when they're about 2. And that is 4.1. Just measure it there. 3.9. Yeah, so that was 7.1 millimetres there, and it's now 3.9. So they're wearing actually really well. So by the looks of it, we're going to get well over 30,000 miles out of the front tyres, and probably well over 60 to maybe even 70,000 miles out of the back tyres. So what I'll probably do is switch the wheels around so the worn tyres are then on the back and the good tyres are then on the front. So they're going to wear a little bit easier, and then when it comes to the point that you need to change the tyres, we'll probably change then all four at the same time. because I know that's more expensive when you do that, and you're obviously changing four rather than two. But then if you're not going to buy the same type of tyre or the same model of tyre, at least then you buy all four the same. However, the Goodyear Vector all-season Gen 3s will still be available, so that's less of an issue here, but I should have probably changed those before now. But anyway, there's an update of what these tyres are wearing like on an electric vehicle. And as you can see, these tyres aren't wearing out any quicker because it's an electric vehicle. That's all a bit of a myth. EVs wear the tyres exactly the same rate as they would if it was a combustion engine vehicle. And EVs aren't really heavier. Again, that's a bit of a myth. So this is a reasonably large family size five-door hatchback, and I think this weighs about 1,550 kilos. I can't remember the exact weight, but I'll put it up on the screen. In fact, I think this weighs a little bit less than the petrol version of this model. But anyway, as you can see, tyres on electric vehicles do not wear any quicker. And these are obviously all-season tyres, and people assume that an all-season tyre will be softer and will wear quicker. That's not the case. They also assume it's going to be noisier. That's not the case either. These were 69 decibels, which is as low as summer tyres in this tyre size and fitment. And they also assume they're going to use more fuel, and that's not the case either. If it does, it's not measurable. It's so insignificant. Okie doke, I thought you might find this little update useful. If you have, please do click the thumbs up. That really does help. Do subscribe to the channel. If you want to know more about the Hyundai Ioniq Electric, there's a link below to a playlist where you can see those videos.